A chapter a day to brighten your way.
The legendary woman who entered grace by faith, Rahab. Hello friends, let us read the Bible together. Today we'll be reading Joshua chapter 2. At this time, the Israelites were camped along the Jordan River. On the other side of the river was the first city on the border of Canaan, the city of Jericho. In order to plan ahead, Joshua sent two spies into Jericho to learn about their enemy. This was a very tense moment because the king of Jericho caught wind of the spies. The whole city was in a state of fear, hunting for these two spies. Would they be able to complete their mission and escape? Let's read chapter 2 together.
Joshua, chapter 2. And Joshua the son of Nun sent two men secretly from Shittim as spies, saying, "Go, view the land, especially Jericho." And they went and came into the house of a prostitute whose name was Rahab and lodged there. And it was told to the king of Jericho, "Behold, men of Israel have come here tonight to search out the land." Then the king of Jericho sent to Rahab, saying, "Bring out the men who have come to you, who entered your house, for they have come to search out all the land." But the woman had taken the two men and hidden them. And she said, "True, the men came to me, but I did not know where they were from. And when the gate was about to be closed at dark, the men went out. I do not know where the men went. Pursue them quickly, for you will overtake them." But she had brought them up to the roof and hid them with the stalks of flax that she had laid in order on the roof. So the men pursued after them on the way to the Jordan as far as the fords, and the gate was shut as soon as the pursuers had gone out. Before the men lay down, she came up to them on the roof and said to the men, "I know that the Lord has given you the land, and that the fear of you has fallen upon us, and that all the inhabitants of the land melt away before you. For we have heard how the Lord dried up the water of the Red Sea before you when you came out of Egypt, and what you did to the two kings of the Amorites who were beyond the Jordan, to Sihon and Og, whom you devoted to destruction. And as soon as we heard it, our hearts melted, and there was no spirit left in any man because of you. For the Lord your God, he is God in the heavens above and on the earth beneath. Now then, please swear to me by the Lord that as I have dealt kindly with you, you also will deal kindly with my father's house, and give me a sure sign that you will save alive my father and mother, my brothers and sisters, and all who belong to them, and deliver our lives from death." And the men said to her, "Our life for yours even to death. If you do not tell this business of ours, then when the Lord gives us the land, we will deal kindly and faithfully with you." Then she let them down by a rope through the window, for her house was built into the city wall, so that she lived in the wall. And she said to them, "Go into the hills, or the pursuers will encounter you, and hide there 3 days until the pursuers have returned. Then afterward you may go your way." The men said to her, "We will be guiltless with respect to this oath of yours that you have made us swear. Behold, when we come into the land, you shall tie this scarlet cord in the window through which you let us down, and you shall gather into your house your father and mother, your brothers, and all your father's household. Then if anyone goes out of the doors of your house into the street, his blood shall be on his own head, and we shall be guiltless. But if a hand is laid on anyone who is with you in the house, his blood shall be on our head. But if you tell this business of ours, then we shall be guiltless with respect to your oath that you have made us swear." And she said, "According to your words, so be it." Then she sent them away, and they departed. And she tied the scarlet cord in the window. They departed and went into the hills and remained there 3 days until the pursuers returned. And the pursuers searched all along the way and found nothing. Then the two men returned. They came down from the hills and passed over and came to Joshua the son of Nun, and they told them all that had happened to them. And they said to Joshua, "Truly the Lord has given all the land into our hands, and also all the inhabitants of the land melt away because of us."
Praise be to God. Though Rahab did not come from a very honorable background, God saw the respect and faith in her heart. This faith turned her life around in a wonderful way. Later, Rahab married an Israelite and was the great-grandmother of David, the king of Israel. The Gospel of Matthew even records Rahab in the genealogy of Jesus Christ. Dear friends, doesn't the red cord tied to the window resemble the lamb's blood that the Israelites painted on their door frames during Passover? Rahab's story actually foreshadows our own lives being saved by Jesus. Though we were not originally with the Israelites, we've received this abundant grace through our faith in God and the price Jesus paid on our behalf. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for allowing me to receive your grace through faith so that my life can be turned around and I can live in your abundant blessing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. A chapter a day to brighten your way. See you tomorrow. Jesus loves you, and I love you too.